Good morning, all of you. Today, the topic of discussion is serial extractions, which is a very, very less understood topic of interceptive orthodontics. It is purely interceptive orthodontic procedure. It doesn't fall into the category of preventive orthodontics. Serial extraction it has got many misconceptions which needs to be clarified before you undergo this particular procedure. You have to gain the confidence of the child, because ultimately you are going to extract around 12 teeth in a row at predetermined time intervals, and you need to motivate the patient as well as his parents to undergo this particular procedure. So for that, it is very necessary that you should be able to understand what serial extraction procedure is, what is the rationale, and how do you practice this particular technique. So first of all, we will start with the definition. The definition of serial extractions is the planned extraction of certain deciduous teeth and some permanent teeth in an orderly and predetermined pattern to guide the erupting permanent teeth into a more favorable position in the oral cavity, when one can recognize and anticipate potential irregularities in the dentofacial complex. Means, as soon as you have started witnessing the presence of permanent teeth in the oral cavity, and there is presence of certain deciduous teeth as well, and you anticipate that the total tooth material is more as compared to the available bone, it is the right time to take the decision to go into the procedure of serial extraction procedures, in which it is advised to extract some deciduous and some permanent teeth, even though their exfoliation time has not reached, so that adequate space is available for the other teeth to be in the comfortable position. Otherwise, what will happen is, when all the teeth will erupt subsequently, there will be a lot of crowding in the oral cavity and severe malocclusion will be there. So, as the definition suggests, it is planned extraction of certain deciduous and some permanent teeth in orderly and predetermined pattern to guide the erupting permanent teeth into a more favorable position in the oral cavity. Now, let's see about some history. Mr. Bunon and Bodet in the year 1973 were the first to recommend extraction of teeth in order to relieve crowding. Then Mr. Linderer wrote something about extraction to relieve crowding. Jellegren introduced the term serial extraction in the year 1929. Nance is considered to be the father of serial extraction in USA. Devil and Tweed, they termed this serial extraction procedure as a pre-orthodontic guidance, and Hodes in the year 1970 termed this thing as guidance of eruption. Now, what is the rationale of serial extraction procedures? It is based on basically two principles. The first is, there is the presence of arch length tooth material discrepancy, means the tooth material is in excess in a greater amount as compared to the arch length. Hence, there is severe need to extract some teeth so that the rest of the teeth they occlude normally. And second point is, then once you extract a particular tooth, then there is by nature physiological tooth movement into that extracted space, and the teeth automatically they move into that space, that is we call it as physiologic tooth movement, resulting into the achievement of a proper occlusion. So these are the two basic principles that you follow in, and then the rationale. Now when we should go ahead with serial extraction procedure? We cannot go ahead with serial extraction procedures even though there is mild crowding. There should be some starting point, or you can say some boundary after which we can go ahead with serial extraction procedures. Now when there is mild crowding, if the tooth material arch length deficiency is less than 2 millimeters, then it can easily be corrected with the help of proximal stripping, like handheld strip, sandpaper disc, or a tapered bud. So as there is mild proximal slicing can result into decrease in the total tooth material, and ultimately the teeth will come into occlusion as the time passes, into proper occlusion by physiologic tooth movement. Now, one thing should be kept in mind, and that is very, very important, that is very, very mandatory, that is when you are exhibiting this particular thing, like when you are stripping these teeth proximally, then don't leave the teeth like that only. It is of utmost importance that you go ahead with fluoride application on those abrased surfaces of the teeth, because as we all know that the fluoride is maximum in the superficial layer of enamel, and once if you have removed the superficial layer of enamel, then the subsequent layer of enamel is very much prone to get caries, and ultimately when the child, if you have not placed fluoride after proximal slicing, and if the child comes after say 3 months, 4 months, you will find lot of caries proximally, and ultimately you are doing more damage rather than benefit to that particular patient. Now, when there is moderate crowding, which is more than 2 millimeters but less than 5 millimeters, you can go ahead with removable appliance, which like arch expansion appliance with expansion screws. You can try to expand the arch, you can try to expand the arch length, because you cannot decrease the total tooth material, but you can expand the arch with the help of expansion appliances. So sometimes this thing can be successfully done, and without going ahead with some extraction of the teeth, you can straight away get some space of 3 to 4 millimeters, and then the resulting teeth will come into occlusion. Now, severe crowding, more than 5 millimeters but less than 10 millimeters per arch, in this only you go ahead with serial extraction procedures. Now, we have understood that how we should progress ahead. First of all, we should do the proper space analysis, and then only after that we should go ahead with, we should determine the space deficiency, and then only we should decide that whether we should go ahead with proximal slicing, we should go ahead with arch expansion, or go ahead with serial extraction procedures. Now, these are the various indications of serial extractions, and each point has got a great importance. What are the indications of serial extraction procedures? The first is you can execute this this technique, you can execute this procedure only in class 1 malocclusions showing harmony between skeletal and muscular systems. Means if there is a skeletal malocclusion, you cannot go ahead with serial extractions. There should be a harmony between skeletal and muscular systems, but there is disharmony between skeletal and dental structures. So then you can go ahead with serial extraction procedures. Arch length deficiency should be less than 10 millimeters, means more than 5 millimeters, it should be in the range of 5 to 10 millimeters. Where the growth is not enough to overcome the discrepancy between tooth material and basal bone, means you are late. The growth of the patient has already taken place to the maximum. So there is particular age limit, and you can do it in straight profile patients. Contraindications, so indication is class 1, so contraindication is definitely, automatically it is class 2 and class 3 type of malocclusion with skeletal abnormalities, space dentition, anodontia, open bite and deep bite, midline diastema, class 1 malocclusion, unerupted malformed teeth, extensive caries, and mild disproportion between arch length tooth material that can be treated by proximal. So these are some of the contraindications that we can find, that we can follow, that these serial extractions like procedures should not be done in these cases. Now, very quickly, we'll come to the three types of procedures. There are basically three types of prescribed procedures. The first one is Devil's method, which we call it as CD4. The second one is Tweed's method, we call it D4C. And the third one is Nance method, that we call it as D4C. But there are some differences in between Tweed's and Nance, which will, depending upon the age at which we extract D and 4 and C. Now, in Devil's method, the first step is extraction of C at the age of 8 to 9 years. Means you deliberately remove the deciduous canine at the age of 8 to 9 years, so that space is free. Then you extract D at the age of 9 to 10 years, and after that you extract within some time the erupting first premolars, permanent premolars. So what happens is, actually you have by extracting C at the age of 8 to 9 years, you have created space, or you have created relaxation in the anterior dentition. If you have relaxed the anterior crowding, so that space is occupied by the anterior teeth. Then you go ahead with extraction of D. What causes when you have extracted D? Because ultimately, when you are going to remove 4, you need to extract D first. So D is extracted, 4 is extracted. Ultimately, in the posterior segment, you are utilizing the space of first premolar, so that the other teeth in the posterior region, they are comfortable in their position. They erupt into the comfortable position. Similarly, the teeth are same, but Tweed's method, it involves first they touch the posterior segment, that is D, that is 4, and then they touch the anterior segment, that is C. And similarly, Nance, they again touch the posterior segment like D and 4, and then C. So very quickly, I have told you the three methods, but in details, the details of this, how we execute and how we do all these types of extractions and why we do these, we'll deal with in next lecture. Thank you.